Cal cable, where you know someone that has it, you can be able to take your kids to their house and they can actually watch themselves on TV, okay? So I will make sure that I get it posted on Facebook, where and when, what times, the days, and that kind of stuff. They felt me running, of course. They're wonderful. They love our kids in town, and we're just thrilled to do these types of things. Let's start with one prayer. Dearest Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this time. For this time of joy, for this time of celebration, for all the things that you've done with us this week, and all the ways that you've made us laugh and share and care. We thank you, Lord, for the food that we've collected this week. We ask, Lord, that you will allow it to bless our community, that you will allow it to put smiles on faces, food in stomachs, and hope in households. We just give you thanks, Lord, that we're able to be a part of what you are doing here. Be in this time, bless the kids' voice, give them strength, and enable them to gladly share all that they've done this week. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. This evening we've got a new face up front here. Stand up, James. Kayleen has been helping with music, but she's also been training a new person, this James. And he's done a really good job this week. He's, you know, it's one of those things, as we all know, as we mature, as we go, he came through this from the earliest classes all the way through, and well, now he's doing it. That's actually a couple of our teachers are too now. It's a wondrous thing, and draw yours.
Thank you. new things.
Tonight, clean up all the time, worry about more important things like people over and stuff like that. So, what did Martha do after you just told
her? Sat down and called the kids.
And Savannah, what was your favorite part of the story?
When they sat down and talked together.
And Clayton, what was the moral of the story? It's like the lesson that you learned. Need to do is pray. And I asked them, like, when do you pray? And
sixth grade class, and much like Jocelyn's class, it's a pretty bright bunch that I've got. And for, as talking with Pastor Boyd last night, he's decided we've been doing this for 11 years. At least I've been a part of VBS for 11 years. And
Bill,
yes?
This is our 13th together.
Oh, that's worse. But being a part of this has been a blessing. For 13 years I've been a part, so I've got to watch. Pastor Boyd points out that I've got to watch progress from here to my class beyond James, Jackson, and others. See you back there as well. Anyways, Nicole's wearing her camera back there. But this group, in all those 13 years, that it's rare that you get a group of kids that gel instantly on that first night. And this is like the third time that's happened, where they knew, they got this little, they've been best friends forever. And it makes it easier for me. They all get along, and they don't care about each other. So this we have to choose kids because we're in fifth and sixth grade, and there's more than expected of us. And so we had 15 minutes to come up with something. So tonight's story, the first one that we're going to tell you, pre-K and K and first, second, third, fourth, listen to the words. We're going to tell you a story that involves fish.
Fish!
It's about the time when the disciples are, they're a quandary. They don't know what to do. This is shortly after Jesus has been put to death on the cross and he's missing from the tomb. And they're afraid of themselves and they're confused because there's rumors that he's out and about. And so they're all amongst themselves right now deciding what to do. And so I'll be narrating a little bit of the story, but they're going to tell you the story through their skin. So, places. Oh, they're going to focus. Here's the boat kind of with you.
There you go.
Jesus is gone.
What do we do?
I just saw him.
What are you doing, Casper?
Ew!
Ew!
So as Zacchaeus, he gets down on a tree, and he takes Jesus back to his home where they have dinner. They have a discussion about what this tax collector has been up to. Zacchaeus has a change of heart, decides that instead of robbing people, he'll do just that.
Love your neighbors as yourself.
And there you go.
See how they accordion these things? That's because they were really really asleep that night, okay? They were quite tired. And so, seeing as they were so tired, Tuesday, sometimes we have to say, well, what did we do last night to wake up and all this and that kind of stuff? But this, but their work for Tuesday night really was a mess. See, they just have a hard time with that one. Right? Mess. When you say your room is a mess, they should be thinking cleanup now, okay? Let me know how this works out, okay? That was part of what we were thinking about. So, the rest of the evening, if you guys hear the word fish, respond that way, okay? That was a wonderful job. We have been so glad to have you guys with us this week. We've had fun. You guys have worn yourselves out. I know your teachers are tired. We've had a great time. They put bunches of food back there. Some of it's salmon and tuna. Which are types of fish? Thank you for the friends we've made. We thank you, Lord, in advance for the people that we've been able to show your love to. And we thank you, Lord, for the love that we will take with us from this place. We thank you for our teachers. We thank you for the helpers. We thank you for our parents and our grandparents. And we just ask, Lord, that you go with us all and watch over each and every one of us. In Jesus' holy name we pray, amen. Okay, guys, each night I've asked them, this is something you might want to cover your ears. Each night I have asked them if they can be noisy enough to be heard on the other side of the stage. And I'll be honest with you, if they ain't making my ears wiggle, I may do it again, okay? So be ready for volume, I'm serious. If you've ever been to a Kiss concert or a Who concert or some of those guys, these guys are trying to be as loud. I don't have a decibel meter, but I'm sure they hit 120, 130. 1, 2, 3!